स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर टू ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 3.4। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर टू यू हैव स्टेटमेंट लाइक दिस, फॉर्म द पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन द फॉलोइंग प्रॉब्लम्स एंड फाइंड देयर सॉल्यूशंस इफ दे एग्जिस्ट। इट इज क्लियरली गिवन यू हैव टू चेक सॉल्यूशंस एग्जिस्ट और नॉट बाय द एलिमिनेशन मेथड। सो यू हैव टू यूज एलिमिनेशन मेथड व्हिच वी यूज्ड इन क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। So for understanding this elimination method, you can go to previous video to check this method, means question number 1 of 3.4. So let us start this, see what is given. First part is, if we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, a fraction reduces to 1. Fraction reduces to 1 means answer will come equal to 1. It becomes 1 over 2, means its answer will come 1 over 2 if we only add 1 to the denominator. What is the fraction? So fraction is not given. So let us start from the fraction. Let fraction is equal to x over y. X is numerator, y is denominator. Rather than writing fraction directly, you can mark let numerator equal to x, denominator equal to y. Then after that you can mark this step. Fraction equal to x over y. But this is also good if you start from fraction equal to x over y, acceptable. So you can start from this. Now what is given in the question? Case number 1 means they have given if we add 1 to the numerator. So if I add 1 to the numerator means x plus 1 and subtract 1 from the denominator means y minus 1. Fraction reduces to 1 means after simplification it gives answer only equal to 1. So we will write it in the proper form, in the form of a linear equation in two variables. So I am going to cross multiply, it will give y minus 1 in the other side, or if you write this in standard form, it will give us x minus y then plus 2 equal to 0. After shifting these two values to the left side, you will have this equation number 1. Similarly, there is another situation given. Situation number 2 is, it becomes 1 over 2, means its answer is 1 over 2 if we only add 1 to the denominator. If we add only 1 to the denominator, it means numerator will remain the same. So you have this equal. Now cross multiply. When you cross multiply, 2 into x, 2x, 1 into y plus 1 will give y plus 1 in the right side. And write this in standard form, 2x minus y minus 1 equal to 0. This will be your equation number 2. So now we have pair of linear equations in two variables. So therefore equations 1 and 2 form required pair of linear equations. So we have a pair of linear equations. Then they have given find solutions if they exist. So let us compare these equations, these two equations, with the standard forms. What are standard forms? I will compare it with a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, and this one with a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, and then we will mark values of a1, b1, c1. So what are A1, B1, C1, A1, B1 and C1, what are their values? A1, in place of A1 here you have coefficient 1, then B1 minus 1 and C1 constant value, that is 2. Then A2, what is A2? Compare A2, in place of A2 you have 2 and B2 minus 1, and lastly you have C2, which is again minus 1. Then we will find therefore their ratios, A1 over A2. What is A1 over A2? It is 1 over 2. Then we will go for B1 over B2. B1 over B2 means minus 1 over minus 1, which will give us 1. So these two are not giving same answer. You don't have a need to solve for C1 over C2. So you have to write, because A1 over A2 is not equal to B1 over B2. Therefore unique solution. We write always, if they are not equal, we write unique solution. So unique solution means solution exists. We have to write solution exists. Therefore, solution exists. And if solution exists, we have to solve this pair by elimination method. So we are going to use elimination method. So why elimination method? Make a heading here. We are going to use this method. I am going to write both the equations now. Again, write together, but in proper form. Equations 1 and 2 can be written as, how will you write this pair? By shifting constant values to the right side. What is coefficient? What is constant value in this? First 2. So this can be written as x minus y equal to minus 2. Shift 2 there in the right side. This will be our equation number 1 in new form. Second, also we have 2x minus y, but here you have 1 with negative sign in the left side. When you shift, it will go as positive 1 in the right side. See, here you have similar values in place of second term, but their signs are equal, so we will subtract. When you subtract, you have to change all the signs before all the values. Then you will be able to cancel terms having y, and you will left with x minus 2x will be minus x. Here minus 3, cancel minus sign, and you will have x equal to 3. So now we have x equal to 3, but still there is one more missing value, that is y. So we are going to start from y now. For y, we have to solve any one equation out of these. So I will put it in 1. So let me erase this. We will solve this equation number 1. This is 1 by using x equal to 3 in it. So I am going to use it. Therefore, x equal to 3 minus y plus 2 equal to 0. Now solve it for answer of y. So you have 3 plus 2, 5 minus y equal to 0 or y equal to 5. So what will be our fraction? Therefore, what is fraction in this case? Therefore, fraction equal to x over y or 3 over 5. So this is our required answer of part number 1. Now we are going to start part number 2. See what is given in that new statement of question number 2. Friends, our part number 2 is, 5 years ago, Noori was thrice as old as Sonu. 5 years ago means it is about past. If we see 5 years back, age of Noori was 3 times than Sonu's age. Then 10 years later, means after 10 years, this is about future, Noori will be twice as old as Sonu. So age of Noori will be double than age of Sonu after 10 years. How old are Noori and Sonu? This is about present. What is their present age? So we will start from their present age. You already know about this kind of questions because we have already done this type of questions in previous exercises. Let us start this. See what is given. Let present age of, start from first person. First name is Noori. So present age of Noori equal to x years. Then present age of second person is Sonu. Its age is y years. Now very first, 5 years ago given. So what is heading here? 5 years ago. Firstly write their ages. What was age of Noori 5 years ago and what was age of Sonu? So age of Noori was, it was x minus 5 years. 5 years less than present age. Age of Sonu was, it was 5 years less, y minus 5 years. Now we will mark according to question. What is given? Noori was thrice as old as Sonu. So age of Noori was more, 3 times more than age of Sonu. So age of Noori was x minus 5. It was 3 times than age of Sonu. So we have to write this in proper form. So we will mark it x minus 5 equal to 3 into y and 3 into 5. 3y minus 3 into 5, 15. Or x minus 3y plus 10 equal to 0. I am directly writing, you solve it and mark this value. Minus 15 plus 15 and 15 minus 5 will give plus 10. This is our first equation. Now second situation is, 10 years later means after 10 years. So after 10 years, very first thing, what will be their age? So age of Noori will be, it will be 10 years more than present age, or we can say x plus 10 years, then age of Sonu will be, it will be 10 years more, y plus 10 years. Now what is given in the question? So I am going to use this space. So according to question, what is given here? They have given Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. So age of Nuri, which is x plus 10, it will be 2 times than age of Sonu. So solve it again to form another linear equation. 2y plus 20 or x minus 2y minus 10 equal to 0. This is our equation number 2. So we have pair of linear equations, but don't forget, you have to check solutions exist or not. So I am going to directly now, what are the values of a1, b1, c1. What is a1? From first equation you can mark. Coefficient of x, 1. b1 it is minus 3, c1 is 10. a2, 1, b2, minus 2, c2, minus 10. And after that check a1 over a2. What is a1 over a2? 1 over 1 or 1. b1 over b2? 1 over minus 2 or minus 1 over 2. Right, because a1 over a2 not equal to b1 over b2. If a1 over a2 not equal to b1 over b2, we can say unique solution is there. So we will mark therefore unique solution. And if there is unique solution, we can say therefore solution exists. And if solution exists, we can use elimination method as given in the question. We have to use elimination method to find answer of this part. So I am going to write these equations, I am going to erase this. So we will use both the equations. So I am going to start from here. We will make a heading in the solution by elimination method. Elimination method is, we have to write equations in proper form by shifting their constant values to the right side. So I will shift their constants to the right side. Equations 1 and 2 can be written as, we can mark them as, firstly x minus 3y equal to minus 10. In first, by shifting 10 to the right side here, x minus 2y equal to 10 in second. See, very first term is exactly the same, xx. If we add, it will give 2x, so we have to subtract. When you subtract, you have to change sign before all the terms in second equation. So cancel similar values with opposite signs, you will have minus 3 plus 2, minus 1, or we can say minus y, minus 20, cancel minus sign, and you will have y equal to 20. And after getting y's value, you can use this value of y into any one equation. So I am going to use this in 1, put in 1. So our one equation was actually x minus 3y, y means 20, plus 10 equal to 0. Or x minus, this will give minus 60 plus 10 equal to 0, or x minus 50 equal to 0, or x equal to 50. So we have x and y with us. Now we will declare our answer by writing these two values in place of first two lines. Means in first two lines, what you marked, try to remember, what was first line? Present age of Nuri. So that present age of Nuri, it is x years or 50 years, because your x is 50, and present age of Sonu, it is y years or y equal to 20 here, y is equal to 20. So we will mark 20 years. This was part number 2. Now next part, third, we will start. Now I am going to start part number 3. In part 3 you have a new topic, which was even in your 9th class, or we can say in 8th class also, there was one question given in chapter 2. Try to remember, the sum of the digits of a 2 digit number is 9. Very first thing, it is about 2 digit number. There is a formula which we have to remember for a 2 digit number, which I will highlight first. Remember that, then we will go further for its calculation. So how we write a 2 digit number? 2-digit number we can express by using its digits in this way. We can mark 10 into 10th place digit plus 1's place digit. So this is a formula which you used already in lower classes. Once it came there. For example, we can mark example also along with it. For example, we have a two-digit number 53. In this 53, you have this and this two places. This is ones place. This one tens place. So we have two digits. If I want to express it, I am able to express it as 10 into tens place, that is 10 into 5 plus 1's place, that is 3. So we can express it. So let us start now. What is given in this third part, very important part. You will see similar parts in old papers also if you have with you. Otherwise, try to search similar questions in other books. You will feel easy then in examination. So I am going to start its proof now. So its proof, here I am going to start. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 9. You know one thing, number is of two digits. Number is of two digits. So, there will be two places. Ones place and tens place in that number. First of all, you have to see what are the places, ones and tens. So, you will start from here. Let ones place digit. It is suppose x. Second, tens place digit equal to suppose y. Students, whatever I am going to write now, remember you have to write as it is many of the lines in examination. Whatever type of question come for two digit number, they will remain the same. So see how. Therefore, given two digit number is, given two digit number is, I will write the formula 10 into tens place digit plus ones place digit. So I marked here tens place as y. So 10 into y plus ones place as x. So your number is 10y plus x. Now we will go for this line. 9 times this number. 9 times this number means 9 tens of this. Number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of digits. Do you have any number obtained by reversing the order of digits? What is meaning of reversing the order of digits? Reversing the order of digits means you have to write ones place digit in place of tens place and tens place digit in place of ones place. So see next how we interchange these digits to find a number obtained by reversing the order of digits. These lines will remain the same in every proof. Whenever you get any question of two digit number, we have to write all these lines as it is whatever I am going to write now. So remember, let me write next number by reversing the order of digits. See what is given after this. Now we will write about two digit number formed by reversing the order of digits. So we will mark, therefore, new, we can mark new two digit number formed by reversing the order of digits. This also you have to write in every question of this type. Means 10 into ones place digit plus tens place digit. So it is 10 into x plus y, or lastly you will have 10x plus y. So we have both the numbers, a given number which was 10y plus x, a new number by reversing the order of digits, that is here 10x plus y. Now I am going towards again this statement of the question, what is given. Let us write here according to question. Now we will follow given values. The sum of the digits of two digit number is 9. What are the digits? X and y, their sum is equal to 9. Rewrite this in standard form. Mark it as first equation. This is our first equation. Second, also 9 times this number. 9 times this number means 9 times given number. Given number is 10y plus x. Is twice. Twice means 2 times. The number obtained by reversing the order of digits. What number you formed by reversing the order of digits? 10x plus y. Solve it and obtain another equation in two variables. So 9 into 10, 90y plus 9x, 20x plus 2y there. Shift all these to the left side. 90 y plus 9x minus 20x minus 2y equal to 0, or write down with x here 9x minus 20x minus 11x, then 90y minus 2y plus 88y equal to 0. So I'm going to erase this. We will go further for writing this pair of linear equations. So we have minus 11 common. So you have x minus 8y inside equal to 0. In next step, you can mark x minus 8y 0 over minus 11, and this will give you x minus 8y equal to 0, or in standard form, because there is no constant term, you can mark 0 here. This will be our equation number 2. Next, our calculation work will start. We will write here condition for checking if solution is possible or not. So I'm going to write here, what is A1? What was our equation number 1? This was our equation number 1, x plus y minus 9 equal to 0. This was first equation. So what is A1? 1, B1, 1, C1, minus 9. A2 here, 1, B2, minus 8, C2, 0. Therefore, what is A1 over A2? 1 over 1 or 1, B1 over B2, 1 over minus 8. So you can say it is minus 1 over 8 also. We can say it is minus 1 over 8. They are not same. So because A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2, therefore unique solution. Or in other words, we can say therefore solution exists. And if it exists, we will solve it by elimination method. So we have to use elimination method to solve it. I marked here. We will write both the equations together to solve them. So I am going to write these two equations here one time. Then we will go further by erasing this total. So equations 1 and 2 can be written as. Why I am writing this? Because I have to shift constant values to the right side. So my first equation's constant I will mark in the right side. X plus y equal to 9. This is first. Here also there is no value 0. So it will be x minus 8y equal to 0. Second, see x, x they are same, so I will change these signs. Means I am going to subtract equation number 2 from 1. Cancel equal values, we will have 9y equal to 9 or y equal to 1. So you have y equal to 1, then we will put this into any one. So I am going to use it in 1. Equation number 1 is there. X plus y means 1 minus 9 equal to 0. Or x minus 8 equal to 0. Lastly, x is equal to 8. And in the end, you want to find here what is the 2-digit number. So we will go back there where you marked given 2-digit number is. And in that formula, we will fill x and y to get our required answer. So I am going to erase this. See what is next. We have tried therefore required, or we therefore given 2-digit number is given. Let me separate this statement, okay. Given 2-digit number is, if you know, it is 10y plus x, already marked there in the starting of question. So 10 into y, y means 1 plus x, that is 8, 10 plus 8 or 18. This was our third part of question number 2. I hope it is very clear to you. I marked all the details. Try to understand, they are very simple. Next, we will start part number 2. Students, this is our part number 4, in which you have Meena went to a bank to withdraw rupees 2000. So total amount she withdraw is rupees 2000. She asked the cashier to give her rupees 50 and 100 notes only. So she want only two kinds of notes, rupee 50 and rupee 100 notes only. Meena got 25 notes in all, total notes. Total number of notes she have only 25 with her, and find how many notes of rupees 50 and 100 she received. So we will start from this last line. How many notes of rupees 50 and 100 she received, we don't know. So we will write in this way. Let number of rupees 50 notes, suppose she received x notes, and number of rupees 100 notes, suppose she received y notes in all, then we will write according to person. It is more easy to write. First situation is she is having 2000 rupees. One thing is clear, she is having rupees 50 and rupee 100 notes. How many rupee 50 notes she is having? X notes. One note means 50 rupees. X notes means how much amount she is having? 50 into X, 50X. Then if one note of 100 costs 100 rupees, she is having Y notes, so means total amount of rupees 100 is 100 into Y. So she is having 100Y. Then when combination of these, amount of 50 rupees notes and amount of 100 rupees notes, total is 2000. So we will rewrite it in the proper form. 50 common, X plus 2Y equal to 2000, or X plus 2Y, this 50 I am going to shift to the right side, it will divide it and you will have 40. So your equation number 1 is X plus 2Y minus 40 equal to 0. Write in the standard form because we have to check solution exists or not. Now one more. Meena got 25 notes in all. Total number of notes 25. And this 25 is combination of number of 50 notes and number of 100 notes. Number of 50 notes X, number of 100 notes Y. So X plus Y is equal to 25. This is the only combination of number of notes. Rewrite this. It will be X plus Y minus 25 equal to 0. This is our equation number 2. So we have these two equations. First of all, let me use this space, vacant space. We will write here A1, B1, C1. What is A1? A1 is 1. I hope you are able to write all these clearly. B1 is coefficient of y in first equation 2. C1 minus 40. Then A2, 1. B2 also 1. C2 minus 25. So we have all the values with us. Now we will write A1 over A2. It is 1 over 1, which is 1 actually. B1 over B2, 2 over 1 or 2. So we will give reason here because A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2. Therefore, unique solution. And if there is unique solution, it means solution exists. And if solution exists, we will mark by elimination method. So we will use elimination method here. Next, what we have to write? We have to write here equations 1 and 2 can be written as. Why we write this can be written as? Because we have to shift their constant values to the other side. So we will shift their constants to the other side, and after that we will start calculation by elimination method. So I am going to erase this. We will write these two equations. So after writing these equations, we will start elimination methods, cancellation. See how equations we have. I'm going to separate this statement. So equation number 1 is X plus 2Y. It can be written as equal to 40. First, second is here, X plus Y equal to 25. Equation number 2. It's quite simple to solve because first term is exactly the same in all the parts, in previous parts and this also. Subtract equation 2 from 1 by changing signs. You have y equal to 40 minus 25, 15. This y you can put in first equation. First is x plus 2y. Y means 15 equal to 40. So x plus 30 equal to 40, or x equal to 40 minus 30. Lastly, you have x equal to 10. So we have x 10, y 15. 10 plus 15, 25 notes. It is verified. Now we have to give answer in the end. I'm going to rub this part. Therefore, number of rupees 50 notes. How many? You used it as x. So x is 10. Number of rupees 100 notes. You used it as y, or it is equal to here 15. So we have our answer of this part. Part number 4. Next is one more part. Part number 5. See what is given in that part number 5. Friends, here is our part number 5. A lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days. एंड एन एडिशनल चार्ज फॉर ईच डे देयर आफ्टर मीन्स व्हेन यू जस्ट इशू अ बुक फॉर फर्स्ट थ्री डेज यू हैव टू पे अ फिक्स्ड अमाउंट वेदर यू आर टेकिंग दैट बुक फॉर वन डे वन आवर और टू डेज और टू आवर्स थ्री डेज बट फॉर थ्री डेज यू हैव टू पे अ फिक्स्ड अमाउंट एंड देन दे हैव गिवन एन एडिशनल चार्ज फॉर ईच एक्स्ट्रा डे देयर आफ्टर मीन्स आफ्टर थ्री डेज इफ यू आर कीपिंग बुक फॉर वन मोर डे और टू मोर डेज दे विल काउंट नंबर ऑफ डेज एंड पर डे यू हैव टू पे सम फिक्स्ड अमाउंट विच इज दे कैप्ट फॉर एक्स्ट्रा डेज दैट इज नॉट गिवन देन दे हैव गिवन सरिता पेड ₹27 फॉर अ बुक कैप्ट फॉर 7 days सो सरिता पेड ₹27 फॉर 7 days वाइल सूजी पेड ₹21 फॉर द बुक शी कैप्ट फॉर 5 days फाइंड द फिक्स चार्ज सो यू हैव टू फाइंड फिक्स चार्ज एंड द चार्ज फॉर ईच एक्स्ट्रा डे सो लेट अस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम लास्ट लाइन इन स्टेटमेंट सम्स ऑलवेज चेक द लास्ट लाइन That will tell you about the requirement of question. So I am going to start from the last line. Let us start it. Let the fixed charge, suppose it is rupees X, then the charge for each extra day, suppose it is rupees Y. Now we will write according to question. What is given? First person is Sarita. She paid ₹27 and she kept book for 7 days. Let us write for 7 days. 7 days. Divide 7 days into two parts. 3 days for 3 days separately and 4 extra days. Because for 3 days, she have to pay how much amount? Fixed charge ₹X. And for 1 day, she is paying ₹Y for 4 days she will pay 4 into ₹Y so let us complete this equation for 3 days out of 7 days ₹X she will pay and for 1 day she have to pay ₹Y for 4 extra days she will pay 4Y so mark it as a standard equation it is x plus 4y minus 27 equal to 0 first one then there is another situation Susie paid ₹21. She paid ₹21 for a book she kept for 5 days. And 5 days we will divide in two parts, 3 plus 2. Because for 3 days she have to pay ₹X for 1 day extra. She will pay ₹Y for 2 days. She will pay ₹2. So it will be 3 days ₹X for next 2 days 2 into Y. This will be x plus 2y minus 21 equal to 0. So we have this pair of equations with us. Mark them 1, 2. Now first of all we have to check conditions. So right here A1, B1, C1. What is A1? 1, B1 from first equation 4, C1 minus 27. From second A2, 1, B2, 2, C2 minus 21. Now I will write conditions. So I'm going to erase this first line, okay? And second line, and I'm going to start calculation of conditions. So you have to write here, separate this statement. Therefore, A1 over A2. What is A1 over A2? 1 over 1 or 1. B1 over B2, 4 over 2 or 2. They are not equal, so we can give a reason because A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2. They are not equal, therefore unique solution. And if there is unique solution, I'm keeping these equations with me because I need these. So unique solution means suppose okay here we have A1, B1, A2, B2 in the denominator. So unique solution, therefore solution exists. And if solution exists, which method will give answer in this case? By elimination method. So we are going to solve it for answer using elimination method. So, first of all, write equations 1 and 2 can be written as. Why we use it? Again, I am telling you, we shift constants to the right side. So, equation first will be x plus 4y equal to 27 and second x plus 2y equal to 21. Very simple again. First terms are equal. We have to subtract 2 from 1. Cancel. This will give 2y equal to 6. And solve it for y. I am going to erase this part. Here we will mark answer of this. So you have 2y equal to 6. Y equal to 6 over 2. Or your answer of y is 3. Then we will give answer of x by using any one equation. So I am going to use it in 1. Put in 1. 1 is x plus 4y. So x plus 4y, y is 3, equal to 27. Then x plus 12 equal to 27. X equal to 27 minus 12 or x equal to 15. So what are these two? You mark in the starting line. So we will declare our answer by using that. Therefore, the fixed charge equal to rupees x or 15, then the charge for each extra day, it will be rupees y or rupees 3, here also rupees 15. So this was our last part, fifth part of question number 2. I hope this exercise is very clear to you. Try to understand and try to solve these questions by yourself once again, because this is very important exercise in examination point of view. So pay some attention to all the questions. Thanks for watching my channel.